Vive, 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 vive Taken from verse 31. But those who wait.
Hallelujah.
But those who wait. We live in a curious world that is always busy. Always busy with things to do. Just thankful we have
such time.
But the word reminds us
this way.
And for us to gain what is purpose, for us to complete the task and the vision, to encompass all of the talents that we have
given,
everything that God has given us, the word tells us we have to wait. This kind of wait is not sitting around doing nothing.
We're
just waiting and seeing if something
happens.
A lot of times our pastor will say, let us sit in
our prayers.
The word he is saying, we must wait. We're not waiting for a bus to come past.
We're
just chewing your gum and waiting for a bus.
And
it seems to be
a person who waits.
In Hebrew it tells us, if you're able to make it on Wednesdays, on Wednesday night, our pastor, she talks about the doctrine of our faith. Pardon me, forgive me, I'll try to continue in time. One of the great doctrines that is shared on Wednesday, the one person of the Holy Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. And as we've heard about
it,
in Hebrew it brings us the translation of
words.
If you bring three threads and you tie them together, it is the waiting with those three
threads.
Because when you entwine three strings together, when we wait upon the Lord, we are waiting on the Lord. We are tying ourselves with God the Son, and with God the Holy Spirit. And in that compass,
then
we can fly. We can soar with that in time. We worry about our fear. Why? Because we are tying our lives How then do we entwine our lives in
Proverbs
4:23?
That
you will seek seriously from that life source. That you will keep seriously in your heart. From that is the source of life. In another translation in English, it says that you will keep it or place it in your mind. That in everything you desire and think is the source of your life. Anyone who chooses to wait, who has a heart that is set on Christ, who completely sets their heart on
Christ.
What is the word saying to us when it's saying this? Because we are staying and living by
the word.
In Psalms 119, we say that I've hidden the word, that I'm tying my life to the Lord. For they who wait upon God, they will gain the purpose and glory. For those who continue to wait, they are tying themselves up for Christ. For those who wait, they completely sell themselves out. When I was younger in Tonga and Hapai, I used to love going with her out to the bush. And when we get out there, we do her gardening. And we learned this term that meant that you would work and as we get to lunchtime, we sit down and we'll drink some coffee. And then once that passed, we would continue. It gives me this picture that I want us to grasp in our hearts. We need to be continuously weaving in our hearts. Why? The word also tells us the seed. That's exactly what we're going to read. There's another example. If you look out at the plot of land there, when the rain falls down on it, green is grass, green is grass. And I want to give you this truth of the Word of God. Whatever you should plant in that soil, it has to show forth fruit. The ground is not going to say, I don't like that soil. That soil is not going to say, oh, I don't want that seed because I don't want that seed. The truth is that whatever you choose to plant in that soil, it's going to fruit. It's going to bring the words that are given from our mouth come from the source of our heart. And we must continue to wait. Jeremiah 29:11.
When
God is saying, He has a plan for you. A plan that you will have life and not that you will be burdened or in pain. A plan to give you a great future. And if you read down from that verse, in that terminus of that
story,
it explains for you the whole purpose of
Babylon.
God allowed his people to be taken as slaves into Babylon. And then God gives his word to his people. Whilst they are still slaves, not a good place to be of pain and strength. Not a good area of rest and freedom. In verse 3, when God says to his people, the place I have put you, work seriously, be determined, praise your you'll notice in verse
2,
and you will pray for peace. In other words, God was saying, pray well for them. Whilst they were in amazing, it continues to speak. After 7 years. After so many years, after 70 odd years, then God said, "I'm coming with me." A lot of times we're tired of waiting. See how God turns
for us.
There's still 70 odd years. Continue to work
faithfully.
From without, no from within. This is source of your life.
Love it. Love it. Siope. Siope.
Job 23.
This is 10.
If you read through that later. Lost Job was facing
the
Lord. Lost everything.
How tall am I?
Job says in verse 23,
Continue
to wait on God.
Guard
your heart. like the translation of God.
They
God is saying He has words and instructions for us. When He says He feels holds for us, see how blessed we are. That we have such a
that
God would have faults for us. That He has awesome plans for us. What about wages young people. How can you straighten the path of a young person?
Use
the word of God.
Never
forget the preaching shared by our mother
Sifa.
That she was wishing and desiring that her husband was still
present. I thought morning for me.
And this truth came to you.
So
this is the only day you have to do God's work. This is the great opportunity we have to serve God. Matthew 5:8. Blessed are those with clean heart, for they will see God. No wonder Solomon, the great wise man, says to God, your heart. That's the only way the salt will
grow.
When the heart is clean. And why the light will still shine in this
world.
Because the heart is clean. The importance of a clean heart.
The
preacher last week spoke
about
how can we stay attached to the
Bible?
When we were waiting on God.
That's how you remain
to get that grace. That's why we won't be pruned in
Christ.
Because our life is entwined with Christ. And we are set to take care of and make sure everything is right. I pray that God will help us.
You follow the best army at David.
And I'll finish off with a psalm from David.
Sambata Toluna, Yari at David and I told the best of the Tolupe.
130.
Otua.
Verse 3.
Kohang of Oloa, I feel Taho for a fee. Kohai for Oloa, I'm on Uia, I can now tell of no for pay of a fee like it.
The psalm statement says, God, how long
will
I be in the same? And then another side of the day says, I'm always thankful because you are my closest
friend.
And in the midst of darkness of my life, and when it is darker than the night,
you
guide my
heart.
David is describing for us when life is at its darkest point, that his heart is still
beating.
Why did David say
this?
Because his heart is forever
singing.
No wonder they describe David as a man whose heart is
beating.
The only way to complete the purpose of God
is
the way in which we can complete the work of God has a vision for this church.
Because
when you put your own life in the hand and with God, you will see with what God sees. When you tie up your life with
God,
when you base it all in your heart, when you face your heart towards Him at all times, that's when you're looking straight at the vision. You're not looking at the errors of your friends. You're not looking at your sister's downfalls and failures. Why? Because it's exactly how Christ is. He saw past my sin. Let me speak this completely with love for you.
Your time, boy, or no flower for the time I get.
And I'm looking at all the problems that my brothers and sisters are going through and
failing.
My life starts to untangle
from Christ.
Notice it's not God who lets
you go.
It's me letting loose of
my faith.
And I'm just reminding us, church,
in
the work that we are destined to do together, let the seed of good fruit
be
planted
entwined
with
Christ. The scripture
that we've
been reading,
we start to blame everything around us, take our focus on God, we start to be self-centered.
Isaiah,
he gives us righteous
peace.
So we are totally
surrounded by God.
Notice the plan of God for your life. He gives you peace with everything. Because sometimes if we look at a little portion of the picture, God sees the whole picture. And when God blesses us, it's not just a blessing for you, but a blessing to flow through you to everyone else. What about we entwine ourselves with
God?
For those who wait, their strength will be renewed. Always be aware of your heart. Plant the right seed there, the good seed, which is from the word of God.
And
no matter what's going on in your situation, you can walk through it with the righteous peace.
And in the scripture, the Lord
tells us that his face is seeking over the whole earth.
He is
seeking, that he is intently looking. He is with those.
Hallelujah!
You want God to be a part of
you.
You want his good hand to be a part of you. No matter what's going on in your situation or your surroundings, if you face your heart, his plan will be
good.
You don't need to worry about what's going on.
How are you doing?
Because when blessings happen to you, my brother and sister, you need
to know. Because
like Job said, God knows that he will bless
you,
that I can be happy and joyful. Why? Because I know.
I will.
This is a God of promises. You might say, it's not going to be.
Because
the seeds you plant is what you
want.
You say, oh no. Because it is. Tying it up with God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit will guide you always to the truth. And the blessings are yours. It's a promise from God. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Koko e oku ke fai tutu ni ki holoto.
Those of you who live
a point.
And who is bossing
you.
Hallelujah. If anyone wants to boast on their own strength, it's never.
How can you have fun now?
Even the kids.
They talk too poor. But you're driving me mad here now. And I'm more weak and now.
They're living in the time of life where they are at their best.
That I'm going to get out of even that fail.
Even that time, they can still fail.
God, we don't fail my law. We're full of our bong bong going in.
For the scripture and the word.
That reminds
us to go back to the word and to wait
for
it. You would entwine yourself with that free fruit and
Trinity
God. That it is very hard to unspoil. And as you stand this morning, the preacher this morning
to be aware,
to be serious about what you put in.
Amen.
And as we've all heard this morning, it is your job alone to protect
your
for what you sow in it, you will reap it.
Oh, I'm going to tell you, Fihia, and I'm going to tell you,
let us not get caught up in blaming and shifting the blame to anyone else.
Our
hearts are precious. Praise the Lord that you live. You are currently in the house of God. You are here to hear His word. The encouragement of the preacher. That Jehovah knows exactly
the path to bring you.
And if you are being faithful to Him in the path He's given you, do not grow weary. Do not give up. For there is a day.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Church, it is God who will reward
you.
Let your heart be pure before Him. Whatever area of your life that you find in God, church, that you need to correct
it.
If we need to make a correction,
you